Hasipoglu, who's an MP for Ersin Tatar's National Unity Party, the UBP. Oguzhan Hasipoglu, thank you so much indeed for joining us. Is this now, do you believe, the end of the possibility of reunification, given Ersin Tatar's desire to strengthen ties with Ankara?
That's what we have been saying since the formation of our party, UBP. We are the party who formed our republic in 1983, and we believe the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus. However, under our independence declaration, we have also a clause stating that the talks under federation will continue, and we have not closed the door to federation negotiations. But now, with this result, we are firmly emphasizing that now a two-state solution will be on the table, because we have been negotiating a federation model since 40 years, and we have no result for this. Now, Turkish Cypriot people decided to vote for their independence and for their country.
But 48% did not vote for Ersin Tatar, so how will you keep that 48% happy?
Obviously, Mr. Tatar will be the president of all the Turkish Cypriot people, and obviously we are not going to close the door for negotiations. The talks will continue, but what we are believe is that not to make the same mistakes and discuss the same models, discuss the same UN parameters. Now, our intention is to bring alternatives on the negotiation table.
What else are you offering the people of the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus, apart from your position on reunification or not? What else did the party and Ersin Tatar offer the people during the campaign?
Well, the first real step was taken by Mr. Tatar, and he has decided to open the closed city called Varosha, Marash. And as you know, it was closed since 46 years, and it was part of the comprehensive federation negotiations, and it was always a region which Turkish Cypriot side supposed to give to the Greek Cypriot community. But with this move, we have emphasized that Marash is our sovereign land, and our rules will be applied there. And we have opened it for all Cypriots, Turkish Cypriots, Greek Cypriots, and the foreign nationals. Now it is possible to walk, take a photo, and the 1974 pre-owners of these properties will have the chance now to see their properties.
How much does the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus rely on assistance from Ankara? In other words, where would you be if you didn't have the support of the Turkish mainland?
Obviously, our relations with Turkey does not solely lie on the financial issues. We are Turks, we are Turkish Cypriots. Obviously, Turkey has always supported us, but Turkish Cypriot intention was never to be a state, a province of Turkey. We have always believed to have our own country, our own independence, and with the election of Mr. Tatar, now we believe that we are going to realize this. Obviously, Turkey's financial assistance will continue, because as you know, we are a country who are under isolation and embargoes with the other countries. But now, with this move, with this victory, let's say, we will have the chance to emphasize the recognition of Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus, which Kosovo people did years ago.
Absolutely. Oguzhan Hasipoglu, thank you so much indeed for your time, sir.